Hello, welcome to Centennial Hall. We're up here on the third floor in the hallway in the middle of the building, and what we have are three student study rooms, 3306, 3307, and 3308. The technology in these rooms is identical, so we'll go ahead and demonstrate in 3306, and you'll be able to use that to use any of the rooms up here. So follow me into 3306, and we'll get things up and running. You'll see here in the room that on the back wall we have a flat screen. Then we have our controller next to the flat screen. And then we have the place where we plug our cables in. So the first thing that I'll demonstrate is how to turn it on. There's an on and off button right here on the controller. When I press on, that's going to power the TV on and bring the system up. And the next thing I can do is I can go ahead and grab my first cable. And the first thing we'll demonstrate is the HDMI, or the digital cable. And now I'm going to hook it into my laptop, but the HDMI can obviously be used for any other device that has an HDMI output. Go ahead and plug it into the HDMI input on the wall, and then plug that into the HDMI output on my laptop. Then I'm going to come up to the controller, and I'm going to make sure HDMI is the button that we have pressed. And then it takes just a second for everything to sync up. And once it does, anything that I'm showing on my laptop is going to show up on the flat screen as well. Now, if your laptop doesn't show up right away, it's probably because your laptop isn't in the correct mode to see an external projector. So you can change that in your control panel, or on a Windows keyboard, the shortcut is to hold down the function key and press F8. You'll see a little menu come up there, and it might scroll through these automatically, but no matter which way you access it, make sure you choose the duplicate mode so that whatever you're showing on your laptop shows up on the TV as well. Now the volume is located right here on the controller. I can turn it up and turn it down, and you'll see that on a TV, the volume meter turns up and down as I turn that knob. And with HDMI, your audio is going to follow along. It's an audio and a video cable, so you won't need a separate audio cable in order to get the audio to work. The next thing I'll demonstrate is the VGA input, and this is more your standard computer input. I'm going to plug that into my laptop as well. I also happen to have a VGA output on my laptop. So I'll plug that in, and then I'll plug the other end into the VGA input on our wall plate. And then VGA is only a video cable, so we'll need an audio cable as well. I'll go ahead and plug into the audio. And then the other end of that goes into the headphone jack on my laptop. Okay, then once I'm all set up there, I come back up to my controller, and I'm going to hit the button labeled PC. Since VGA is standard for PCs, that's what the button is labeled. And so then we have our picture that comes up on the screen. And our volume will now be controlling whatever is coming along with the VGA signal. We also have two other types of inputs, component input and composite input. And I'm going to use a DVD player to demonstrate both of those types of inputs. The first one we'll do is the composite input, which is kind of your standard RCA connectors here. I've got a video, which is going to be the line out. And then I've got my two audio, the red and the white, for the left and the right audio. Then that cable's going to go ahead and plug in right on the right-hand side. Red and white for the audio, and yellow for the video. Then I'm going to come up here onto my controller, and I'm going to hit the video button. And that's going to start playing the video from my DVD player. And I can adjust the volume up and down there. The last thing that we'll demonstrate then is the component, or it's, as it's labeled here, YPRPB. And my DVD player here has a component output. And so I'm going to go ahead and match up my cables with the component output. Now you might have a component video cable that matches the green, the blue, and the red. I don't have one with me, so I'm just going to make sure that they correspond with each other. So I'm going to use the yellow for the Y, the white for the PR, and the red for the PB. And then I'll just need to remember that yellow goes with the Y, red goes with the PR, and white goes with the PB. And then that will only do video for me. I'll also need audio cables. And so I'll go ahead and grab my audio cables, and I'll plug them into the audio output, and then into the audio input on my plate here. Once I've got everything hooked up, then I come up here and I'm going to hit the button labeled Y, P, PR, PB. And nothing's going to show up for me because I haven't told my DVD player or whatever device you might have, could be your video camera, could be something else, that I'm going to use the component output. Switch to the component output and there you go. Now I have the video and my audio can be adjusted using the volume knob once again. Now you saw me press that button and you heard the audio go away. That's because I hit the audio mute button. You'll see it's flashing red there when the audio is muted. If I want to bring it back, I simply hit it one more time. And the last button that we have on here is an auto image button. And that's if, particularly for a laptop, you might have your image kind of off the screen or it might look just a little bit off kilter or something. You go ahead and hit that auto image button. It's going to resync everything together so that you have a nice image there. When I'm all done with whatever it is I'm doing, I'm going to go back here to the display area and I'm just going to hit the off button. That's going to take away any video or audio that we have, and it's also going to power off the TV. So thanks for watching. If you have any questions or concerns, please contact Academic Technology Services, and we'd be happy to help. Thank you.